Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, Admiral Michael Mullen.
Mr. Vice President, Mr. Secretary, distinguished guests, and most especially families, friends, and loved ones of those killed near this spot on this day back in 2001. Good morning and welcome. Let me begin by offering, on behalf of the 2.2 million men and women who wear the uniform of the United States Armed Forces, by passing my deepest condolences to you for the loss you suffered and the grief you still endure. No music can assuage, no tongue can express, no prayer alone may dampen the yearning that must fire yet inside you. Lives ended in this place. Dreams were shattered. Futures were instantly altered. Hopes were tragically dashed. You come here, we all come here, to remember those hopes and to mourn and to honor. But the greatest honor we bestow, the finest tribute we pay, lies not in our gathering. It lies in our hearts. It lies in our deeds. It lies in the manner in which and the degree to which we have preserved the very ideals that others tried to kill when they killed innocent men, women, and children. I was struck by the words of a young woman who just wrote a letter to her dead father, a firefighter killed at the World Trade Center. "Dear Dad," she said, "I still feel your presence. You are with me every day. You inspire me to live my life, to help others, and to be grateful for each moment. I don't know what the next 10 years will bring, but I do know that I have enough strength, wisdom, and support to take on anything." Tara Feinberg remains proud of her father, Alan, and of the sacrifice he made so that others need not. And she has committed herself to proving worthy of that sacrifice. Hers is truly the greatest monument, the most enduring memorial, as it is with all of you. You, the families, have shown the rest of us the way, quietly honoring the memory of your loved ones by how you live and what you do. It's in the children and grandchildren with major league dreams, the college degrees earned, the businesses started, the wedding celebrated, the charity given, and the love and the laughter shared. These are the things the terrorists could not eradicate. They could bring down the walls, but they could not bring down America. They could kill our citizens, but they could not kill our citizenship. And in that spirit and with that pride, a whole new generation has been inspired to serve, many of them in uniform. Indeed, from this place of wrath and tears, America's military ventured forth as the long arm and clenched fist of an angry nation at war. And we have remained at war ever since, visiting upon our enemies the vengeance they were due, and providing for the American people the common defense they demand. 2 million men and women have deployed to combat since 9/11, volunteers all. Some of them knew a colleague killed here. Some of them were but grade schoolers on that day. All of them have remained dedicated to making sure a day like that never happens again. They've done this with great skill and bravery, but they have also done it with a realization learned over time and at great cost that sometimes we defend best our national interests when we help others defend their own. and that sometimes in war, it isn't the enemy lives you take that matter most, but rather the innocent lives you save. It's a lesson you have helped teach us. And when that war takes the lives of our troops, when it snuffs out the futures of so many bright young stars, we again look to your example. We wrap our arms around the families of our fallen the way you have wrapped yours around each other. The Scottish poet Thomas Campbell, in his poem Hallowed Ground, tells us that to live in hearts we leave behind is not to die. Today we stand on this hallowed ground to honor those who still live on in our hearts. But as we mark the end of this decade of war and remembrance, I hope we will also follow in Tara Feinberg's footsteps, heeding the better angels of our nature, never forgetting, being grateful for each moment, helping others, and most of all, living life and living it well. That is victory. Thank you.